Once again, our green and pleasant land is now under threat as never before. Not from invading hordes or European conquerors, but from Parliament, local government and national housing developers. Local people are being sold down the river by those they placed in power, and it's all in the name of profits for the few and spurious claims of national housing shortages. Here in the former mill city of Bradford, many local Labour councillors should be hanging their heads in shame, begging forgiveness from their electorate for having failed them so miserably. How difficult was the task of maintaining the replacement unitary development plan, the people ask. And let us not forget the city's unelected mandarins. Should they now be toppled from their ivory towers and forced to answer for their Del Boy style of wheeling, dealing and horse trading? These people, these organisations, this motley crew would steal from us our green pastures, our children's heritage, and would see nature herself bulldozed and laid beneath the concrete, brick and fake stone structures that would have looked equally uninspiring had they sat upon one of the many brownfield sites this city so jealously protects. In our nation's dark and distant past, we have had Mrs. T steal the milk from the mouths of our young schoolchildren, but even she would not have dared to sink so low as to steal their school places from them. Yes, you brave and courageous people of Britain, once again, your countryside needs you. So pick up and wave your banners high, and with one determined voice, shout out throughout the land.
That's corruption, and it should be legally overturned.